attention in entertainment. Peter Lemongello. A mood rock experience called Love 76.
He couldn't get a label interested in him, so he came up with the idea to market his own albums. He bought commercial spots and went on like 100 times a week.
Peter Lemongello. Do I love 76? Watch for it.
He's credited with inventing the infomercial.
Do I love you? Must I show you how? Do I love you?
Don't you know by now? To order Love 76, send $6.98 for records or $8.98 for 8-track tape.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Ryan.
Peter.
Peter?
I'm also Peter.
Also Peter. Peter Jr. and Sr.
Yes, sir.
What style of musician and singer were you?
It's called mood rock.
Mm-hmm.
Almost disco.
And you have like a throwback look to you. Is that is that the way you sing?
Yeah. Well, I sing a lot of the early rock and roll songs in the 50s and 60s.
It's like the hair has a 50s and 60s gel.
My dad had his career, and now he's kind of stepping aside, retiring, and he's passing it on to me, and now I'm starting my career.
This way. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Give us your name, who you are, and where you're from.
My name is Peter Lemongello Jr.
Lemongello. Yes. Very good.
I'm 19 years old from Boca Raton, Florida.
Now, your father's pretty famous.
Yeah, my dad was the first singer to sell over a million albums on television in 1976.
Wow. So what are you going to do for us?
I'm going to do I Can't Help Myself by the Four Tops.
Really?
That's my friend.
Please.
Huh?
That's why I'm friends with the Four Tops, the Temptations. I was actually just with them on Friday night in Atlantic City.
Really?
In Atlantic City?
Yeah.
How old are you?
19.
Wait a minute. It says 19. You're an old soul. Okay. All right. So let's hear this.
Okay. Thank you.
Fire them away.
Or wink your eye, I come running to you.
Running to you.
I'm tied to your apron strings, and there's nothing that I can do. Each day, love gets a little stronger.
Okay, wait. By the way, you just left those guys.
Yeah.
Those are the exact routines, I'm telling you. Exact.
Do you live this lifestyle?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
What year car do you drive?
Well, I'm saving up to buy a 1959.
I was going to say, you're getting 55 to 59 right there, man. How did you get locked in the 1950s, man?
I just always loved that music.
That's incredible.
And through my dad, he'd take me to a lot of the shows. I get to meet a lot of the guys, a lot of, you know, become friends with guys like Lloyd Price and Chubby Checker.
Lloyd Price. He's in my dad's era, man. This is, are you kidding me? This is amazing. Luke, I'd love to get your impression.
Well, I mean, I think it's just about polishing up your voice, getting a little stronger vocally.
Yeah. Maybe you need to put a little spin on it to keep people's attention.
There's something in there called business for you, but I don't think it's going to fly for what we're looking for in American Idol. Let's take a vote.
Go ahead.
I'll go first. Great meeting you, but it's a no for me.
Peter Lemongello.
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 Lemongello. I'm going to roll the dice. Why not? It's a yes.
Very good. Luke, give us the answer.
For Idol, I'm a no.
Very good.
All right.
Thank you. I feel okay. I guess I'm a little disappointed, but, I'm not heartbroken over getting rejected, you know.
Everybody who's had any success in show business has had a lot of defeats along the way.
Right. That's
so it should motivate him to fight even harder.
Right.
And I think it will.
I was surprised to get a note from Lionel Richie, and he just said he didn't think this would fit for the Idol. And then the other guy, he, I don't think he liked it from the minute I walked in.
This may be the end of Peter's